Kris Kringle was born in a small village in Germany. He grew up a happy boy in a happy and well-to-do family. Life was good to Kris, and he knew nothing but love and happiness. One day, after he had grown into a young man, Kris heard a distraught-looking man say he was worried about the fate of his three young daughters. As a poor man, he had no dowry to offer for his daughters, and he feared for what they may have to do to survive once he passed away. Being the kind and caring young man that Kris was, he was deeply touched by this man's story. On the eve of Christmas, very late at night, when he knew all would be sleeping, he snuck over to the home of the man and threw three sacks of gold into the girls' room. But that wasn't enough for Kris. Kris wanted to make sure that every child in the world would have a Merry Christmas, so he made it his mission to make sure every child, regardless of their financial status, got nice presents on Christmas morning. As his operation grew, he needed the help of others to travel the world, and he needed a bigger center of operation to work from. So he and his new wife, along with his helpers, set out to the North Pole, where he knew he would have plenty of space to base his Christmas giving operation. And that is how the young Kris Kringle became the legendary Santa Claus. Hi, everybody. This is Lady Sweetheart, and welcome to a very special, and yes, very special Christmas CAS video. So today I decided, wouldn't it be fun as a CAS to make a young Santa Claus, you know, before he actually became Santa Claus, and kind of explain what his story might have been. I actually did a little bit of research on the history of Kris Kringle, which is obviously one of the myths that led to the idea of Santa Claus. There are several, and they kind of all got bunched up together into what we now today know as Santa Claus. But I looked up information about Kris Kringle, and honestly, there wasn't a whole lot. Although the story about the man and the three daughters was actually part of the story that I found. And the rest I just kind of filled in based on what seemed like it could have been that happened. So as far as the actual cast, I gave him red hair and blue eyes because I remember when I was a little girl watching, I don't even remember what Christmas show it was, but it was like a claymation type of show, and it had Kris Kringle in it when he was younger, and he had red hair and blue eyes. So that's why I decided to go with that. And I made him just kind of how I thought, you know, Santa might have looked like this when he was young. And as far as the traits that I decided to give, I gave him the friend of the world aspiration. I feel like I'm using that aspiration a lot for these casts I've been doing, but it really was the most appropriate one that I could find. And I gave him the good trait because obviously he's motivated to do good things, and the cheerful trait because we all know that Santa Claus is quite jolly. And I gave him the foodie trait because we know Santa, that man loves his cookies. So anyway, and the other thing is I did decide to dress him in an older style because I know that the legend of Kris Kringle took place a long time ago. So I did my very best to dress him in outfits that looked similar to what you might have found back then. I mean, obviously, I was limited by what you can do in The Sims, but I did my best. And you'll notice at the end when I show the outfits, I don't show all the outfit categories just because I kind of felt like some of them weren't relevant, like a swimming outfit. I don't even think that people had swimming outfits back then. You know, they didn't have pools. And if they went into the lake or something, I don't know that they had a special outfit for that. So anyway, I want you to let me know in the comments down below what you thought of this video and what you think of Mr. Kris Kringle here. And I hope you all end up being on Santa's nice list this year. I'll see you later, my little sweeties. Bye.